Newsflash, they are absolutely lying to you about the economy right now. It's been reported that the inflation rate dropped from a peak of 9.1% in June of 2022 to 3.4% in April of this year. And of course, the administration, the media are all celebrating this progress. Bidenomics. President Biden wants you to tell you how great it is, right? However, inflation is still running rampant. It's persistent, and it's still well above the Fed's target rate of 2%. And despite what the administration is saying about positive trends, many economists are cautioning the American people that high inflation may be the new norm. Americans should brace for this possibility. I mean, think about how interest rates right now have come to a new norm, the interest rates that we have. Yes, we may see some slight decreases in the coming years, but we will never, ever going to see rates again down to the 3% range. I mean, I say never, but my God, these crazy people at the Fed and the Biden administration, I mean, who the heck knows? But I don't think we're ever going to see 3%, you know, interest rates again for mortgages. As inflation continues to run at an elevated rate, more and more Americans are using unsustainable methods to try to make ends meet. A new Wells Fargo study found that 35% of people admitted to dipping into their savings or retirement accounts just to cover basic expenses. Meanwhile, people are going deeper and deeper into credit card debt. Consumer debt in the fourth quarter of 2023 reached over $1 trillion, according to data from the Fed. This is the Fed Bank of New York saying this. And while people are struggling to pay their bills, every month the Biden administration continues to lie to the American people. As I covered in another video, Biden has been spouting this nonsense that inflation was at 9% when he took office, which is a bold-faced lie. And the Fed talks about the possibility of future rate cuts and lowering inflation, giving Americans a false sense of hope for a more secure future. But we all know the truth. None of these markers can move significantly enough to impact the daily lives of Americans. You guys feel it in your cost of cheese and eggs and bread, just to live, your cost of gas, your rental heat, you know, your rental prices, your heating costs, all of it. These are real world costs that you notice every night when you sit down to feed your family. When your wages can't keep up with the cost of living, then your standard of living has to go down. And this is exactly what really matters to people, right? Who cares about what's happening in the macroeconomic level when it's hurting your wallet just to put gas in your car, feed your family? And if you've seen any of my content before, you know that not only are these old systems failing, but they're bringing down people in the process, exactly the way they were designed. Your retirement program isn't designed to make you wealthy. It's designed to line the pockets of Wall Street. And the vast majority of politicians aren't looking out for your best interest either. The credit card companies, right? They've created this whole system to trap people. This economy has created hard times for so many people, and it's hard to watch lives be destroyed right now. I hate watching it. And I hate especially the older generation that should be retiring right now. And they're having to take on additional part-time jobs just to keep a roof over their head and pay their bills. America is not taking care of these people. People are just going further and further into debt, hoping that they can come up for air soon. We'll get back to that video in a minute, but first, I need to tell you about a golden opportunity for investors that's happening right now. Mortgage rates have plummeted in anticipation of the Federal Reserve cutting interest rates at their upcoming meeting in September. Now, it's good news for buyers, and it has presented a unique overlap in the investing world right now. Remember, when mortgage rates spiked last year, well, a lot of sellers started offering incentives to help investors achieve positive cash flow. For example, my company, Morris Invest, and our team over at Sidera Wealth started offering clients a rate buy-down credit. Now, a rate buy-down drastically reduces your mortgage payment. If you've ever run the numbers on an investment property, you know that's a big deal. Now, here's where the golden opportunity comes in. When mortgage rates change, it can take a while for other things like seller incentives to start catching up. So even though you can get a mortgage rate in the low sixes right now, and that could be even lower by the time you're seeing this video, right now you can also lock in a rate buy-down credit on top of that. And this is huge, people, huge. With the two combined, our team's finance expert said he's seeing our clients locking in rates he hasn't seen in years. But here's the catch. The window of opportunity here is very narrow. This overlap will close very soon. So those seller incentives are going to fall off very, very soon. There are two more reasons to move quickly on this. One, prices are rising week over week. And now that rates are going down, they're going to spike even more dramatically, which will be made worse by two. increasing competition. Potential buyers have been sitting on the sidelines just waiting for rates to drop. And now that they have, they're going to flood the market, reproduce bidding wars, pushing prices even higher. If you need a refresher on the advantages of owning real estate, like how it delivers four streams of income through number one, appreciation and equity gains, number two, principal reduction by your tenants, number three, tax benefits and depreciation, and number four, cash flow, I'll link another video in the description so you can check that out. But if you've done your research and you already understand why build-to-rent properties in high-growth rental markets are a great path to financial freedom, then take action right now. You do not want to miss out on this opportunity to fast-track your investing strategy. Cash in on this narrow overlap of lower rates and seller incentives while it's here. Click the link below and schedule a free call right now. It could be the most important call you make this year. I think we should believe the economists who say that inflation is here to stay because it's better to be prepared for the worst case scenario. As I've been saying time and again, if you want to protect your family from all these factors, it's going to come down to basic financial intelligence, right? You need to build financial intelligence. So in this next video, you're going to learn about the foundations of financial intelligence. I'm going to show everything that I know about assets, liabilities, saving money in a smart way, building a strong financial education, and so much more. So click that video next. I'll see you in the next video. And thank you guys so much for subscribing to the channel.